Morning, morning. It's Sunday. Yay. You know, I woke up this morning with, I was really, really tired, but then as soon as I stepped into church, like, my energy just went all the way up. I was so excited, you know. We come to learn, to worship, to catch up, you know. I was just, like, so excited, you know. But anyway, let's stand. We'll sing a couple of songs.
This Let it be. Hey, you're probably wondering what all this is going on around you on the different tables today. I want to start by reading some scripture to you this morning. It's from Mark 13, from 32. They came to a place named Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here until I have prayed." And he took with him Peter and James and John and began to be very distressed and troubled. And he said to them, "My soul is deeply grieved to the point of death. Remain here and keep watch." And he went a little beyond them and fell to the ground and began to pray that if it were possible, the hour might pass him by. And he was saying, "Abba, Father, all things are possible for you. Remove this cup from me. Yet not what I will, but what you will." And he came and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter, "Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for 1 hour? Keep watching and praying that you may not come into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to answer him. And he came the third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? It is enough, the hour has come. Behold, the Son of Man is being betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. Behold, the one who betrays me is at hand." That's quite a powerful piece of scripture right there. And if you notice, the disciples, what are they doing? They're sleeping. And what is Jesus asking of them? To watch and wait with him. I think that's so important because we often consume God and don't spend enough time in relationship back with him, right? So this morning, I've sort of lined up a little bit of a mini retreat for us, an opportunity for God to be at the center of our actions today. And so what I've done is I've set up stations of Easter or of the cross. And so you can work your way around the church. You can talk to each other, but just be mindful that this is going to be a prayerful time, a time of focusing on Jesus, of watching and waiting with him as if you were in that garden, right? So here we have... Sorry, mustn't stand close to that mic. There is some myrrh resin that is burning in that burner there. And myrrh is something that was given to Jesus when he was born, and it's prophetic of his death. So as you come to this table, I want you to just spend some time in worship, considering all he has done for you. Okay. At the back here, we have some sand with some candles in it. Jesus was aware of the desert places as much as we are. He came to earth as a human being, and so he lived life. What I would like you to do is to read Isaiah 53, and then read this little notice I have here in blue, and light a candle and spend some time in prayer over here. Sorry, I'm making you turn around. In 1 Peter 5, 7, Peter said that Jesus said, "Cast all your cares on him because he cares for you." So Jesus is our high priest, and right now he's praying for us in the presence of the Father. So write down some of your deepest concerns. Fold them up so that they are private and place them in the hands, okay? The hands of Jesus. And then spend some time in prayer. Okay, over here. So, you all know I like to garden, but I'm not sure if it's flax. Either that or it's a piece of grass. So, take some flax and weave it into a cross. I've given you an example of how to do one here, right? And it's, how can you follow Jesus? He said, "Take up your cross and follow me." So read the scripture in Matthew, And as you are reflecting on that, form this cross that you take with you, all right, as a symbol. Okay. Jesus lived a perfect life, and he offered himself up as a perfect sacrifice on our behalf. And because of that, our relationship is restored with God, and our sins are forgiven. So I want you to take a paper towel after reading Jeremiah 31 and write your name on the paper towel, okay? Then get someone around here to pour water over your hands as an act of cleansing, and dry your hands with the paper towel. You'll notice that the Sharpie is red. The blood of Christ covered our sins. Does that sound good? Yeah? And the last one, we've been working our way through the resurrection eggs. And in one of them was a rooster, right? What does the rooster stand for? Yes, because Peter betrayed Christ three times, right? So this is a reminder to us to be strong in the faith and not to fall into temptation and to deny Jesus. So there's a reading of the story in John 13. And then James 4:7 says, submit yourself then to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. So spend some time here asking God and his Spirit to strengthen your faith for the times of testing. Okay? Is that clear? Has anyone got any questions? So move amongst them. You don't all have to go to the same one. Go to the one closest to you and read the instructions and just spend some time focusing on Jesus this morning. Remember, you're giving back to him now. All right, this is a time for us to worship him. Okay. Pick your space and off you go.
Praise the Spirit, three
Jesus coming before the throne of God and saying, "Here I am. I'm willing to do your will." Okay? You are so loved and so cherished by God. Just remember, when you feel down, where is that coming from? Right? You have so much in your favor. God right now has provided the way. Jesus is in heaven constantly praying for you. So no matter what you're going through, draw that to mind. You have a Savior who knows everything about you, and he prays daily for you, and he's working it out. He will show you the way. Pick up your cross and follow him. That's the best thing you can do. And then cast your cares on him, because he knows how you feel. So I hope that was a really special time for you all. Yeah? Remember, you don't have to only do this when you come to church. You can find ways of incorporating this every day of your life. You know, he's all around us in the beauty of his nature, in the love of a friend. God is in his people. So be encouraged today. Yes, that's all I wanted to share with you. So let's pray. Father God, we are so grateful for your great love for us, Jesus. That you were willing, the perfect man, Jesus, to just surrender everything for our sake, to die on that cross, Lord. And we've heard this morning that it wasn't an easy road for you, but you did it because you honor the will of the Father and you love us so dearly. So let your cross do its work in our hearts, God. Spirit, be at work within us. Lead and guide us on your path. We can trust you, Lord. Thank you for your prayers for us daily. Thank you for your support for us. Even when we can't see a way, you are already working it out. And we are so grateful for that. Bless everyone here this morning, Lord. I can see many have been touched in their hearts, and I pray for their protection now as they leave this place in a little while after this time of worship, that they would call to mind the things they have felt here this morning and remember how much you love them. In Jesus' name, amen.
We're going to sing No Longer a Slave. It wasn't the plan, but I feel like we should, because like, we're no longer a fear for our sin, our fear, you know, stuff that we've been struggling. I think this is a very good song.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God.
From my mother's womb.
From my mother's womb. Oh, you have chosen me. Love has called my name.
I've been born again.
Oh, I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer